Everyone, welcome to Arpita Sharma classes. I am Arpita Sharma. As usual, we are back with the mock test based on the Hindu newspaper, the daily mock test series that we are launching based on the Hindu newspaper. This is based on 21st May 2022, the Hindu newspaper. So, iske andar jo bhi important articles we are finding in the newspaper, we are creating mock tests based on those articles. And today we have created special mock test. From the perspective of preliminary examination, daily I am giving you mains based questions also, right? But today this is purely based on the preliminary examination because the prelims are approaching us now. 5th June को prelims हमें approach कर रहा है, तो हमें कोशिश करनी है कि हम prelims के लिए डट के तैयारी करें and prelims के लिए पहले से pre-prepared रहें, okay? So keeping that fact in mind, we have created this lecture and this is a kind of test for all of you also. So make sure that you let me know your scores in the comment section. नीचे comment section में अपने scores बताना, मुझे बिल्कुल भी मत भूलना, ठीक है? Before we move ahead, here's a very wonderful announcement for all of you. Those of you who are preparing for the prelims 2022 or prelims 2023 exam, do not miss this chance. UAI PMT 2022 launched by Unacademy. This is Unacademy All India Prelims Mock Test, which you can give offline also and online also. Now, this is the first kind of, prelims mock test that Unacademy has started. It's an all India based mock test jo offline hoga and it's going to be conducted in Delhi, Prayagraj, Jaipur, Pune, Hyderabad. So if you are in one of these cities, make sure that you get the address from the Unacademy's website. It has been updated already and do not forget to reach the center before 9:30 AM tomorrow because GS paper aapka start hoga 9:30 se 11:30 and CSAT ka paper hoga 12:30 se 2:30 बजे तक. तो ये होने वाला है कल 2022 को May 22, 2022 एंड हियर यू कैन इनरोल फॉर फ्री. दिस इज नॉट अ पेड मॉक टेस्ट. आप फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट इनरोल कर सकते हो इफ यू यूज दिस कोड Arpita10. सो द लिंक इज गिवन बिलो इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स. क्लिक ऑन दैट लिंक, इनरोल एंड यूज कोड Arpita10 एंड प्लीज रीच द टेस्ट सेंटर, ठीक है, विद योर इनरोलमेंट रिसीट. अपने टेस्ट सेंटर पे पहुंचिएगा और वहां जाके इस टेस्ट को प्लीज प्लीज अटेम्प्ट कीजिएगा बिकॉज विदाउट इनरोलिंग इफ यू गो देर आर हाई चांसेस दैट यू माइट मिस द सीट्स. ओके, अगर आप बिना इनरोल किए पहुंच जाओगे तो सीट्स आप मिस कर सकते हो. तो दैट इज वाई इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू टू इनरोल. ओके, प्लीज 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 डू अटेम्प्ट दिस टेस्ट बिकॉज इससे क्या होगा, आपको एक्चुअल यू विल गेट दी एक्चुअल एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ द प्रिलिमिनरी एग्जामिनेशन, द रियल प्रिलिम्स एग्जामिनेशन. यू विल अंडरस्टैंड योर ओन साइकोलॉजी वाइल गिविंग द टेस्ट, कि टेस्ट सेंटर में किस तरीके से स्ट्रेस होता है, कैसे हम सिली मिस्टेक कर देते हैं स्ट्रेस में आकर, एंग्जाइटी में आकर. तो वो सारी चीजें आप पहले एक्सपीरियंस कर लोगे तो एक्चुअल एग्जाम में आप उन मिस्टेक्स को रिपीट नहीं करोगे. दैट इज व्हाई दिस इज अ मस्ट फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू. एंड ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर नॉट इन दीज सिटीज और हु वांट टू गिव द टेस्ट ऑनलाइन, वी आर आल्सो लॉन्चिंग Unacademy अल्ट्रा कॉम्बैट एंड इट इज गोइंग टू टेक प्लेस टुमारो. बट यू कैन गिव दिस टेस्ट ऑनलाइन, लाइव टेस्ट होगा. आप ये टेस्ट को ऐप पे भी दे सकते हो, Unacademy के वेबसाइट पे जाके भी दे सकते हो. 60 मिनट्स का टेस्ट रहेगा, 56 क्वेश्चंस विल बी देयर एंड यू कैन इनरोल फॉर फ्री इन दिस ऑल इंडिया बेस्ड स्कॉलरशिप test using code Arpita10. Top 3 rankers are going to win MacBook Air, iPad and Samsung Mobile. 500 lucky participants are going to win the Amazon gift vouchers worth rupees 10,000 to 5,000 to 2,000. Starting with the first important article, which is on page number 1, 29 phones tested for Pegasus spyware, says Supreme Court. So Supreme Court has said that its technical committee had so far received and tested 29 mobile devices. These are suspected devices which it has found that basically suspect ye suspect suspicion is baat ka hai kiske andar Pegasus software aa chuka hai ya dala ja chuka hai to gain access. It's a malicious software to gain access to the mobile phones, theek hai, to the devices, and that too without any knowledge of the user. So this was the answer of Supreme Court. Supreme Court is looking into it because last year se Pegasus has been in news and that is why Supreme Court has said that we have to take the security of our data very seriously. Now the question can be, consider the following statements about Pegasus. It's a type of malicious software or malware classified as a spyware. So yahan par I told you that it's a malicious software. First, point is correct. But it is classified as a spyware. Iska matlab kya hai? When I say that it's classified as a spyware, it means, so here स्पाईवेयर का मतलब है जासूसी करना, एंड इट इज सेड दैट the data which is stored on the devices of a person without the knowledge of the person, that data can be accessed by anybody who has put that you know spyware in the mobile phone. So जासूसी के लिए इस particular you know spyware को या malware को use किया जा रहा है. So first statement is absolutely correct. When first is correct, you can easily eliminate option D and option A. Okay, now you are left with two options. Second, it is designed to gain access to devices without the knowledge of users and gather the personal information. Again, correct, that we have just now discussed. Two option is also correct. Okay. Third, Pegasus has been developed by the Israeli firm NSO Group that was set up in 2010. Because since last year it has been in news, we know that Israel has, you know, developed this particular, the NSO Group in Israel has developed this particular spyware. So that is why third statement is also correct. So you get the correct answer as option C. Option C आपका absolutely correct answer है. Now did you understand how we used the you know elimination method? आपने समझा हमने elimination method कैसे use किया? When we knew that first statement is correct, we automatically discarded option D and option A. This is how you need to use the elimination method. इस तरीके से ना आप elimination method questions में use कर सकते हो. Please keep these methods and tricks in your mind. Okay? Question number two. It was launched in 2018 with an aim to spread awareness about cybercrime and building capacity for safety measures for chief information security officers and the frontline IT staff across all government departments. So which scheme we are talking about, you have to identify that. See, now you must be wondering, ma'am, when we are studying about Pegasus spyware, how to study about these schemes also? When you search about the Pegasus spyware, you will also search about data security to, you know, take down notes for GS paper 3, internal security. Okay, so in that case, when you are researching about data security, you'll obviously come across these kind of schemes and centers. Okay, so jab aap search karte ho na, aap newspaper padhte ho, to usse related topics ko aap Google pe search karte ho, to aapko in extra information milti hai to add to your syllabus. Okay, and plus we know data security is a part of paper 3, so when you study according to the syllabus also, then also you come to know about these schemes. So do not worry, we are not asking something which is out of the blue. So you have to stick to the news, syllabus. And when you study the newspaper, you know, according to your syllabus, you automatically gain more access to the small topics, little topics of your syllabus as well. Okay. So here the correct answer will be, यहाँ पर आपका correct answer हो जाएगा A. Cyber Surakshit Bharat Initiative was launched in 2018. इसका aim क्या था? To spread awareness about cyber crime, building capacity for safety measures for the CISO, frontline IT staff members of the government departments, etc. So to create awareness about cybercrime, the scheme was launched. Okay. Question number three. In 2017, this platform was introduced for internet users to clean their computers and devices by wiping out viruses and malware. Identify the scheme. So here the correct answer is, यहाँ पर आपका correct answer है, साइबर स्वच्छता केंद्र. देखो, वेरी इजीली यू कैन ऑल्सो यू नो हियर डिड्यूस फ्रॉम द क्वेश्चन इटसेल्फ. टू क्लीन देयर कंप्यूटर, स्वच्छता वर्ड, स्वच्छता मीन्स क्लीनिंग. ओके, तो ऑटोमेटिकली देखो, थ्रू द क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो यू कैन गेट द डायरेक्ट हिंट टुवर्ड्स द आंसर. यू हैव टू बी वेरी विजिलेंट वाइल रीडिंग द क्वेश्चन, वेरी अवेयर बाय यू नो वाइल रीडिंग द क्वेश्चन. Question number 4 पे आते हैं. Now question number 4 says, in 2017 it was developed to scan internet traffic and communication metadata, which are little snippets of information hidden inside each communication, that is metadata. Okay. Now coming into the country to detect real-time cyber threats, so you have to identify the scheme. तो 2017 में इसको develop किया गया internet traffic को और communication metadata को scan करने के लिए. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पर ताकि किसी भी तरीके का real-time cyber threat है, छोटे से छोटा भी, वो भी detect कर लिया जाए. तो यहाँ पर correct answer होगा National Cyber Security Coordination Center, because obviously elimination method आपने use कर ही लिया यहाँ पर. Okay, so it is the national, because you are trying to detect any kind of cyber threat coming from anywhere. So that is National Cyber Security Coordination Center. Question number 5, it is short for malicious software, refers to any kind of software that is designed to cause damage to a single computer, server or computer network. Ransomware, spyware, worms, viruses and trojans are all varieties of this malware. Okay, we are talking about, देखो यहाँ पर question यहाँ पर गलत बनाया. क्योंकि यहां से हम इस चीज को ना हटा सकते थे, तो आपने डिटेक्ट कर ही लिया होगा, यस इट इज बी मॉलवेयर। मॉलवेयर आपका यहाँ पर करेक्ट आंसर हो जाएगा। बट व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज मॉलवेयर, ये होता क्या है? सो मॉलवेयर इज अ मोर जेनेरिक टर्म विच कैन बी यूज्ड टू रेफर टू अ, राइट इट डाउन, नेफेरियस सॉफ्टवेयर। ओके, नाउ बेसिकली इट इज स्पेसिफिकली डिजाइन टू डिसरप्ट और टू डैमेज अ कंप्यूटर सिस्टम, दैट यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर। बट वॉट आर ट्रोजन्स? ट्रोजन्स इज अ काइंड ऑफ मॉलवेयर, बट यू कैन नॉट डिफाइन ट्रोजन एज अ मॉलवेयर। ट्रोजन्स, they are programs that pretend to be something that they are not. Okay, that is Trojan. Trojan क्या है? इस तरीके के प्रोग्राम है जो pretend करते हैं कुछ और but होते नहीं है। इसमें malicious additions भी किए जाते हैं। Okay, and spyware is also a subdivision of malware. That also you have to remember. That can steal your password details, logins, details or personal info, etc. If they are into your computer or your phone. So B is the correct answer. Question number 6, consider the following statements. A zero-click attack helps spyware like Pegasus gain control over a device without human interaction or human error. Pegasus works by sending an exploit link, and if the target user clicks that exploit link, then the malware or the code that allows the surveillance is installed on the user's phone. So here the correct answer is, yahan par aapka correct answer ho jayega C. Both the statements are absolutely correct. Now coming on to the next article, FDI inflow highest ever at $83.57 billion. So foreign direct investment in financial year 21-22 has touched the highest ever figure of $83.57 billion. This was confirmed by the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. So here the question can be, FDI, consider the following statements. FDI is the process whereby residents of one country, that is your home country where you are residing, acquire ownership of assets for the purpose of controlling production, distribution and other activities of a firm in another country, that is in abroad. Second, it is same as FPI, foreign portfolio investment. Third, foreign direct investment brings more than simply money, it also brings skills, technology and knowledge. Which of the statements is or are correct? Kaun sa statement yahan par correct hai? As we all know, statement 1 is absolutely correct. Matlab, if you are in US, if you are a US resident, you are investing in India, okay? That means FDI is ko foreign direct investment. It's a kind of foreign direct investment. Okay? And when you are investing, you are bringing your skills also. Okay? When a US investor will invest in our country, he will also try to bring his skills so that our country will perform better, तो उसकी investment भी increase होगी, right? So third statement is also correct. But the second statement is saying that it is same as FPI, that is wrong. FDI is not equal to foreign portfolio investment because here the person who is investing is from another country, okay? So FPI is, it is grouping of assets like stocks, bonds and cash equivalents. That you have to remember. ये छोटी-छोटी बातें हैं जो आपको याद रखनी हैं, ठीक है? Another important point is, foreign portfolio investment, it consists of securities other than the financial assets which are passively held by the foreign investors. Isme bhi foreign investors are there, but they hold their securities passively. But in FDI, the securities are held actively. Plus, FPI is a part of country's capital account and it is shown on its balance of payment site at that area. FPI is also known as hot money. Isko hot money bhi kaha jata hai. That also you have to remember for prelims. ठीक है, it does not provide the investor with direct ownership, but in FDI direct ownership is provided in some examples to the foreign investor. Okay, इसमें FPI में direct ownership is not given to the investor. So second statement is wrong. तो correct answer यहाँ पर क्या हो जाएगा जब second statement गलत है? A will be the correct answer over here. Question number 8, which of the following state had launched Rajiv Gandhi Kisan Nyay Yojana to encourage the farmers to produce more crops and help them get the right price? So this image was there in the Hindu newspaper on page number 5. Please have a serious look at the images which are also published or the posters which are published. Okay? So here the correct answer is A, Chhattisgarh. यहाँ पर लिखा हुआ था छत्तीसगढ़ जो हमने hide कर दिया आपके लिए. Okay? Question number 9. Consider the following statements about Rajiv Gandhi Nyay Scheme. Under Rajiv Gandhi Kisan Nyay Yojana, which is based on registered area and area under cultivation during Kharif crop season 2019, rupees 10,000 per acre will be deposited in the bank accounts. Very carefully read the statements of the farmers as agricultural help or assistance grant for sowing the crops like paddy, maize and sugarcane. According to government, at least 19 lakh farmers will benefit from the scheme. State government had allocated rupees 5,756 crore in budget 2021 and the money will be given to farmers in 4 installments. Very carefully read the statements. Correct answer yahan par kya ho jayega? Correct answer will be C. All the statements are absolutely correct. Now, even if you are, you know, solving the questions incorrectly, even if your answer is incorrect, there is nothing to be disappointed about. Okay, you are learning something new. If you are marking it incorrectly, that means you are learning the solution via this lecture. So you are increasing your knowledge base. That is good. If this question now, you know, is asked in the actual prelims exam, you know the correct answer. So that is why do not ever be disappointed with your mock, you know, answers or your mock scorecard. Do not ever be disappointed. Because it's very bad, it's very, you know, you can say a student becomes very lazy and lethargic if he is not attempting the mocks, because then he is only studying and he does not know how the questions can be asked from the topics that he is studying. Okay, and then he becomes more and more fearful. So please stop this, you know, stop giving yourself excuses if you really want to clear this exam. अगर आप एग्जाम को क्लियर करना चाहते हो, एक्सक्यूजेस देना छोड़ दो. छोटे छोटे एक्सक्यूजेस है, कल दे देंगे टेस्ट, आज नहीं दे रहे, या टेस्ट छोड़ो, सिर्फ सोल्यूशन देख लेते हैं और रिवाइज कर लेते हैं. ये आपके जो एक्सक्यूजेस है ना, यही रीजन है आपके यू नो कह सकते हो वीक परफॉर्मेंस का, या यही रीजन है कि क्यों किसी बच्चे का एग्जाम क्लियर नहीं हो रहा, क्योंकि वो छोटे छोटे एक्सक्यूज अपने आप को दे रहा है. हमको एक्सक्यूजेस से ही तो बचना है. वी हैव टू सेव आवरसेल्फ फ्रॉम द एक्सक्यूजेस. यू आर योर ओन सेवियर. नोबडी इज गोइंग टू कम. इवन इफ यू प्रे अ लॉट, that doesn't mean that God is going to write your exam for you. You are going to attempt the exam. ये मत समझना कि नारियल चढ़ा दिए तो भगवान हमारे साइड में है, मॉक्स नहीं दे रहे तो भी हमारा एग्जाम तो निकल जाएगा. नहीं होगा. आपको खुद ही एग्जाम लिखना है. आप किसी के ऊपर ये रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी नहीं डाल सकते. इसीलिए आज से ही प्लेज कर लो कि हम एक्सक्यूजेस नहीं देंगे. ठीक है. Question number 10. Consider the following statements about Jawahar Rozgar Yojana. The JRY was meant to generate meaningful employment opportunities for unemployed and underemployed in rural areas through the creation of economic infrastructure and community and social assets. This Yojana jo hai, these Yojanas we are studying, these are from the time period of Rajiv Gandhi ji kya, reign, or you can say leadership. So now second statement, Jawahar Rozgar Yojana was launched on April 1989 by merging NREP and RLEGP. Which statement is correct? कौन सा statement correct है यहाँ पर, जल्दी से बताएं. Both the statements are absolutely correct. C आपका यहाँ पर correct answer हो जाएगा. Coming on to question number 11, Constituent Assembly of India formally adopted Constitution of India that came into force on 26 Jan 1950, 26 Jan 1947, 15th August 1947, 15th August 1950. Please let me know your correct answer. यहाँ पर जल्दी से correct answer बताएं. Very easy, very easy. Correct answer is yes, it is A. 26 Jan 1950. Next question. Basic structure of Indian Constitution stands on Government of India Act 1920, Government of India Act 1936, Government of India Act 1935 और Indian Independence Act 1947. जो हमारा basic structure है Indian Constitution का, वो किस act पे base कर हमने किया है, किस act पे आधारित है, या foundations कहाँ से हमने ली है. We have taken the foundations from, yes, it is Government of India Act 1935. Question number 13. In 1934, Dash first proposed the idea of Constituent Assembly. Indian Polity, M. Lakshmikant, Chapter 1, first paragraph, you'll have your answer. If not Chapter 1, at least Chapter 2 or Chapter 3 mein, first paragraph mein aapko aapka answer mil jayega. Correct answer is yes, it's A. M.N. Roy. Question 14. Which schedule was added to protect the land reforms and other laws included in it from judicial review? So M. Lakshmikant again, judicial review chapter. Correct answer here is yes. Correct answer yahan par hai C. 9th schedule. Coming on to question number 15, which Constitutional Amendment Act introduced the GST? Again, a very easy question. कौन से कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट एक्ट ने जीएसटी को एड इंट्रोड्यूस किया था? तो करेक्ट आंसर यहाँ पर आपका हो जाएगा, इट इज ए, 101st अमेंडमेंट एक्ट इंट्रोड्यूस द टर्म जीएसटी. कमिंग ऑन टू क्वेश्चन 16, कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स. द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन डे इज ऑब्जर्व एनुअली ऑन नवंबर 26 टू मार्क द एनिवर्सरी ऑफ अडॉप्शन ऑफ इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑन 26 नवंबर 1949. Government of India declared 26 November as Constitution Day or Samvidhan Divas in 2015. Year of 2015 was 125th birth anniversary of Ambedkar, who played a key role in drafting of the Constitution. Previously, it was celebrated as National Law Day. So here the correct answer will be, yahan par correct answer ho jayega, yes, it is D. All of the above statements are absolutely correct. Now the next important article on page 11, you have election body curtails perks of CEC and ECs. So election commission has decided to curtail or to stop certain perks which were available to the chief election commissioner, election commissioners at the first meeting since CEC Rajiv Kumar took charge on May 15th. So yahan par election commission has reviewed the perks and privileges which were given to the officials. Okay, for example, income tax exemption on 34,000 rupees monthly sumptuary allowance and 3 LTCs a year for self and dependent family members. तो यहाँ पर इसको review किया जा रहा है जो इनको perks दिए जाते थे, chief election commissioner को and election commissioners को. So here the question that they can ask is, consider the following statements. Election Commission of India is an autonomous constitutional authority which is responsible for administering union and state election process in India. Second statement says it was established in accordance with the constitution on 15th Jan 1950, which is also celebrated as National Voters Day. So you are getting your hints also. Aapko aapke hints bhi mil rahe hain statement mein hi. The secretariat of the commission is located in New Delhi. The body administers election to the Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, state legislative assemblies in India and offices of president and vice president of the country. So here you have to identify the incorrect code. आपको incorrect statement इसमें से identify करनी है. So which is the incorrect statement? We know that here second statement is incorrect. It was established in accordance with constitution on 15th Jan 1950, National Voters Day. I told you are getting your hint, not 15th, it is 25th. So second statement aapka absolutely galat hai. So here the correct answer will be C. Next question, consider the following statements. Originally the commission had only one election commissioner, but after the Election Commissioner Amendment Act 1989, it had been made a multi-member body. The election commission shall consist of chief election commissioner and such number of election commissioners, if any, as the president may from time to time fix. Correct statement इसमें क्या है, जल्दी से बताएं. Very good. Both the statements are correct. C आपका correct answer है. Okay, before we move ahead, here's a small announcement for all of you. So here Unacademy is giving you a wonderful opportunity for your preliminary preparation. Now, if you are taking an Unacademy Plus Iconic subscription, अगर आप Iconic subscription Unacademy Plus का लेते हो, then you will be getting 10 printed booklets along with your subscription to ace your UPSC CSE preparation. Now, you must be wondering, ma'am, what is the usefulness of these 10 printed booklets? It's very simple. You are going to practice 10,000 plus topic-wise questions. Now, when you prepare your topics in the UPSC CSE syllabus, we often get stuck at one place. We prepare the topics very well, but then we think that, you know, if there were questions related to this topic, you know, prelims-based questions, and we could practice it, it would become much more useful. Okay, so here Unacademy is giving you that chance. If you prepare topic-wise, okay, in UPSC CSE examination, you prepare your syllabus topic-wise, and here you will get questions also, prelims-based mock questions also topic-wise. So whatever you are learning and studying, you are practicing it simultaneously. through the help of these 10 printed booklets. Plus, you will get previous year questions from 2013 to 20 with detailed explanations. And Unacademy Combat, which is conducted every Sunday, the questions that are asked in this combat, they will also feature in these booklets with solutions. Okay, so you are getting wholesome, you know, you can say list of questions, topic wise also, previous year question wise also, plus Unacademy Combat questions also. You're getting every question that UPSC can possibly frame in these booklets. So do not miss this offer, because it's a limited time offer and it is available only with the Iconic subscription. Plus you can get 10% discount on your subscription if you use code ARPITA10. Ye code use karke aapko easily 10% ka discount bhi mil jayega. And the books will be delivered within 75 days of your purchase of the Iconic subscription. Coming on to question number 19, consider the following statements on Election Commission. The commission consists of one chief election commissioner and two election commissioners. The secretariat of commission is located in New Delhi. At the state level, election commission is helped by chief electoral officer, who is an IAS rank officer. And the president appoints CEC and EC. So which statement is correct? Yahan par kaun sa statement aapka absolutely correct hai? We know that yes, president appoints the CEC. 4 to aapka correct hi hai. So A will be eliminated, B will be eliminated. Now here they are saying at the state level election commission, it is held by chief electoral officer, jo IAS rank officer hota hai. Correct. Ye to news mein rehta hi hai. Plus you are preparing for this exam, you know about it, right? I am assuming that you know about it. Second statement is also correct. Secretariat of commission is located in New Delhi. Correct. First bhi aapka correct hai. So C bhi eliminate ho jayega. D is the correct answer. Coming on to question number 20. Consider the following statements. Originally, the commission had only one election commissioner but was made a multi-member body through 42nd Amendment Act. Chief election commissioner can be removed by President of India. So, which statement is correct? Kaun sa statement yahan par correct hai? Which statement is correct? Correct pucha gaya. Kaun sa statement correct hai? Now, why neither of them are correct? Why D is the correct option? Because originally, the commission had only one election commissioner. But after the Election Commissioner Amendment Act, please write it down. After the Election Commissioner Amendment Act of 1989, it has been made a multi-member body. ठीक है, point clear? Not after 42nd Amendment Act. तो यहाँ पर first आपका गलत. Second, Chief Election Commissioner can be removed from office only through a process of removal, which is similar to that of Supreme Court Judge by Parliament. So again, it is wrong. Okay, both the statements are wrong. Now the next important article, Norms Eased for GM Crop Research. So Department of Biotechnology has issued guidelines easing norms for research into the genetically modified crops. So here the question can be, consider the following statements. Probably the best known variety of GM rice is the golden rice. Second statement, India has not approved commercial cultivation of only one GM group, GM crop, that is BT cotton. Third, GM food crop has been approved for commercial cultivation in the country. So select the incorrect statement. आपको यहाँ पर गलत statement select करना है. कौन सा statement आपका गलत है? So here the wrong statements are 2 and 3 are wrong. दोनों ही गलत हैं. So B is the correct answer. India has approved the commercial cultivation of BT cotton. And GM food crop has been approved for commercial cultivation in the country. Again, this is incorrect. Because no GM food crop has ever been approved for commercial cultivation in the country. Okay. But in the confined field trials, we have allowed certain GM crops. Field trials में हमने allow किए हैं, but वैसे हमने अभी commercial cultivation के लिए किसी crop को allowance नहीं दी है. Okay? Question number 22. The article is government reconstitutes central advisory board on archaeology. Central advisory board on archaeology that is meant to strengthen contacts between archaeological survey of India and those in the field of archaeological research was reconstituted after 7 years. Okay, so here consider the following statements about central advisory board. It has been reconstituted for a period of 3 years to promote closer contact of archaeological survey of India with the researchers. Correct statement hai ye. First is correct, that means D will be eliminated. Second, the board would also include, to yahan par B bhi eliminate ho jayega. The board will also include 5 persons nominated in their personal capacities by Government of India. Again, this statement is also correct. C is the correct answer. Now, the next important article is, yahan par hum dekh lete hain, next article hai, ED attaches assets worth 192 crore in PACL India case. To yahan par ED ke baare mein hume padhna hai, Enforcement Directorate ke baare mein. Now, I'm assuming that you are learning how to identify what we have to study about in the newspaper through these lectures. Consider the following statements on Enforcement Directorate. It's a multidisciplinary organization mandated with the task of enforcing the provisions of two special fiscal laws, FEMA and PMLA. In the year 1957, this unit was renamed as Enforcement Directorate. So, Administrative Control is Directorate ka Department of Economic Affairs se Department of Revenue mein transfer kiya gaya tha 1960 mein. तो आपको यहाँ इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट आइडेंटिफाई करना है. विच स्टेटमेंट इज इनकरेक्ट, गलत स्टेटमेंट कौन सा है. बोथ आर करेक्ट, डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. नन ऑफ दी स्टेटमेंट्स आर इनकरेक्ट. कमिंग ऑन टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 24, कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स. द लेबर फोर्स पार्टिसिपेशन रेट एसेंशियली टेल्स व्हाट परसेंटेज ऑफ टोटल पॉपुलेशन वॉन्ट टू बी पार्ट ऑफ द वर्क फोर्स. सेकेंड स्टेटमेंट, A low labor force participation rate means fewer people are making themselves available for economic activity. Again, second statement आपका क्या है यहाँ पर, correct है कि incorrect है, जल्दी से बताओ. Yes, second statement is correct, but you have to identify the incorrect statement. तो incorrect statement आपका कौन सा है? One is incorrect. A will be the correct answer. Labor force participation rate, it tells us what percentage of people who are within the working age. Working age is 15 to 59 years. Or, you know, the percentage of people who are within the working age group, what to be part of the workforce. That is the labor force participation. ठीक है? Point clear हो गया? Question 25, consider the following statements regarding National Family Health Survey. National Family Health Survey started in 1990s. It is conducted in a representative sample of households throughout India. And it is the only survey that the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare conducts. Third, it is conducted at an interval of about 4 to 5 years. So, kaun sa statement yahan par correct hai, ye aapko batana hai. Which statement is correct? Yes, very good. यहाँ पर ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर बिकॉज सेकेंड स्टेटमेंट इज रॉन्ग. एक्सट्रीम वर्ड आ गया यहाँ पर ओनली. सो दिस वॉज योर टेस्ट फॉर टुडे. ये था आपका आज का टेस्ट. आई होप यू एंजॉयड गिविंग दिस टेस्ट बिकॉज थ्रू दिस टेस्ट यू आर नॉट यू नो जस्ट लुकिंग एट योर स्कोर कार्ड, योर इम्प्रूवमेंट डे बाय डे. थ्रू दिस टेस्ट यू आर ऑल्सो लर्निंग न्यू इन्फॉर्मेशन, यू आर ऑल्सो एक्सपैंडिंग योर नॉलेज बेस. ऑलवेज लुक एट द पॉजिटिव साइड, द ब्राइट साइड ऑफ अ सिचुएशन. ओके, डू मेंशन मी योर स्कोर्स इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. अपने स्कोर्स जल्दी से जल्दी मुझे कमेंट सेक्शन में बताना.